very salient point, but we have to keep to time. 2.5 minutes from Ms. Monescu.
Thank you, Mr. President. Dear Commissioner, I salute your initiative on promoting a sustainable trade approach. As we already know from previous successful experience, FTA is the perfect entry door for many other policies, programmes and areas of EU's interest, such as human and workers' rights or environmental issues. The Gulf area is a top priority for the EU as well. Related to this area, EU has much more topics on its agenda than just trade. Defence and security cooperation, the fight against terrorism and regional cooperation for the support and stabilisation of surrounding regions, especially the Middle East and the Sub-Saharan Africa. And all of these are high on EU's priorities agenda. Unfortunately, the EU-GCC negotiations for an FTA are suspended since 2008. In line with the current debate on the ways to improve EU's trade agreements, I would like the Commission to consider the possibility of a country-by-country approach in the Gulf area. The EU already signed successful FTA with many third countries. I don't see why we can have a similar approach in relation with the GCC members. The Commission must know already that there are several GCC countries open to a bilateral FTA with the EU. We all know Oman as a successful, stable country, a role model for the whole region, and we also notice the remarkable progress made by Qatar in its legislation concerning the protection of workers' rights and labour conditions, changes that have been already noticed by both ILO and United Nations. These two countries can represent a good start for a new approach in FTA negotiation to be considered by the Commission for this region. Such a proceeding has the potential to unlock the process for the whole GCC. We can even use the experience from a different area of policy, the visa regime. A liberalisation in the EU relation with UAE was followed by a clear increase in trade between the parties and improvements in the same time of the human rights situation in the UAE. Therefore, visa liberalisation can also go hand in hand with the negotiation for free trade agreements with these countries and others in the region. Thank you.